a bouquet, we say proportion wise, should be no more than a third of the bride. Yeah? And that's like your proportions. If you remember about your scales and proportion, we say a third of the of the actual bride.
So you definitely take into account her height.
Yeah. Okay, that's if you're doing it right. As it, but when Lady Di got married, remember she had a really long bouquet? So at that time, I was doing in the shop, like bouquets right to the ground.
Mm-hmm. Right, so that was the fashion?
It was the fashion. Oh. Yeah, and at the moment, mainly hand-tied to the fashion, although some people do go for a slight traditional. So the bride could have a traditional shower, and then all the bridesmaids have the tied poses. All right. So again, if you've done your like your tides, that might look good as a set on your portfolio. So this is the soft ruscus, and it's ideal because it's actually coming up small into large. You've got your transition. So measure, and then I've got a 70 wire, and then I'm going to go round. So a single leg mount, and that is going to go right touching the bottom. Like so, and then it's going to go round the frame. So anything that's long, you want to sort of attach it so that it doesn't come out. Right, and then I'm going to get my shape. It's better to get your shape with your flowers. It's up to you if you want to use it moist or dry. I always use it. Can you see that you can actually get some that are dry? And in the shop, always used to have the dry foam, and we had like a glue dip, and that we used to, that's like a liquid glue, and we used to dip the ends into the glue and actually put them in, so there's no way that they would actually come out.
Is that when the orange is wet?
Right,
but
yeah.
It
dries
out a lot.
Yeah. Sorry? Yeah, so I mean, why I'm not particularly keen on wetting it is because it does sort of dry out, and then you know your osmosis that you did last year?
Mm-hmm.
So it actually starts taking away from the flowers because it's drying out, because that's only a little bit of water. But really, that's my sort of theory, so that's why I usually keep it dry. And really, just putting it in actually seals the ends of the stems. It's really important that you spray on the outside. That's really important. And anything that's a bit dodgy, as in, you know, like your misianthus, you know, like the little buds.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they go overnight, don't they? Yeah, even in foam. So I would leave that sort of thing same day. The lisianthus, anything that's a bit soft, I would leave right till last minute, really. Yeah. So can you see, I'm getting my shape, making sure that it actually touches the framework. So this is going to be quite Christmassy, so why not put some Christmas in? It sort of smells nice as well, doesn't it?
Sorry, Maxine, that's me.
So sometimes people call these teardrops, don't they? Shower bouquet teardrops, because it's that sort of shape. So go. If you turn this upside down, it's only like your front-facing arrangement, isn't it? If you think about it as well, it's your corsage shape. Right, so it's all the things you've learned before. Right? I think the only thing that you've got to experiment in is not putting them in too deep so that this collapses. Or if you don't put it in enough, then they all fall out. So that's where practicing, you've got to find which is how deep you go. Yeah? Rosemary's quite popular with the rye, isn't it? So that would give a nice smell to the bouquet. And we quite often see that commercially, don't we? They spray the foliages. Right, so you're going to look at your roses and look to see which is the most open. So you might want to remove some of the petals. Hiya. Right, so that's going to be my focal. And like you would do in your funeral designs, remember, anything that is vulnerable is support wire. So I'm going to do my support wire, my focal, and that...
That's 70 wires still, yeah?
Sorry?
70 wires?
So why did you... Think of it, can you see from the side, that is... Yeah. It's my handle there, so it should be coming up from my handle, right? So that's a good indication. That's your focal. Then you want to get perhaps the smallest one. So I'm gonna really have my roses coming down through the middle, like my. Can you remember what this is called? This one?
Naomi.
Yeah. And if they need supporting, then support wire them. So these roses are A2. Can you remember what A2 is?
A2.
Vicky, what's A2? What does that mean?
A2.
I mean, that's why they're really reasonable. Naomi at 29p. Yeah, because they've got slightly bent stems, perhaps a bit weaker.
But sometimes bent stems can work in your favour.
Yeah. But otherwise you might be paying two or three times the amount. So it's better that we get lots of other different flowers. Remember, within our budget.